Here's Daphne. This is all blocked off with extra stuff because Bella likes to go under the fence, and then she gets in there, and then she can't get out. So we just keep it blocked off so she doesn't go under there. And there's Lily peeking at us. And the horses are right up here, as usual. But I wanted to do a little video, actually. Have a little talk type thing. And I want to talk about veterinarians and how important they are to your homestead. A lot of people have the mindset that you need to avoid a vet or veterinarians at all costs. And I understand that because from a financial point of view, yeah, you want to avoid them. But they are not the enemy. They are not to be really avoided. They are partners with you. And you should have a working partnership with them. Because sooner or later, you're going to need them. I don't care how good you are at doctoring your own animals, how well you take care of your animals, no matter the best husbandry, the best feeding practices, the best worming schedules, etc., etc., still do not prevent all injuries and illnesses. I've seen that happen over and over, especially with worming and goats. People have a really excellent worming schedule, and they'll have one goat in their herd that gets a bottle jaw or something else like that, you know, gets a real heavy worm load, and they can't figure it out because they worm everybody the same, and they wonder why this goat got it. And it's because not every animal has the same resistance to parasites, and you're going to find one every now and then that is just prone to pick up parasites for one reason or another. That's just an example. And you may need veterinary help to help you with that animal if you decide not to cull it or whatever. And if that's your attitude that, well, if they get so injured or so sick that I can't get them better, I'll just, you know, I'll euthanize them. Well, okay. But what if it's a production animal in its prime that has a malady that can be fixed? Now, that's just poor business sense. I mean, if that production animal is going to give you years of service yet ahead of it, and for some simple thing you won't pay the veterinarian, or you're not willing to pay the veterinarian, that's not a wise choice. That's kind of being penny wise and pound foolish, as they say. Yeah, you're going to chew on something, so I yell at you. You are so typical. Typical kid. Anyway, so you do need a veterinarian. And the time to call a veterinarian is not when you're in crisis mode. You want to establish a working relationship with them before that. You want them to know you and your animals and your place, and you want to get to know them. I'd hate to call a vet blind that I didn't know for one of my animals. I want them to know who I am and which animal I'm talking about, and for us to have some history. Because something else happens. Animals don't work around your schedule. They really do things inconveniently. You're leaving for church or to go listen to your daughter's piano recital, and somebody decides to hurt themselves, or a horse decides to colic, or somebody decides to give birth a week early. You know, this is what happens, and it's always a week night, or the middle of night, or a holiday, or a weekend. And so if you have to call the vet on an on-call situation, I want them to give me priority and my animals priority. And if they know me as a regular client versus someone they never heard of, guess whose house is probably going to get the attention first. Now, yeah, they do triage their on-call emergencies to some extent, but they also cater to their clients. So there's another reason to establish a working relationship, Lily, with your vet. Coda! There, are you happy? Are you happy? He's moved over and he's chewing on this one now. Oh my gosh, they're so typical. He got yelled at, now he's happy. So, you know, I know a lot of people, they try to do a lot hands-on themselves. They pick up their shots every spring, or they do all their own worming, and that's excellent. You should know how to do those things. But at the same time, it's really good to have a vet out once a year just to run a check on your animals, do your spring shots, whatever the case may be, so they get to know you. And so you can talk to them without being in crisis mode. And you can pick their brains. I look forward to that. I look at it as my time with the vet. I have them exclusively all to myself. I can run by any questions I have and pick their brains. And that's really cool, you know. And then if I do have a crisis, they are familiar with what animal I'm talking about and me. And so, yeah, you can try to avoid the vet, but sooner or later you won't be able to unless you're willing to take a big loss. And that's usually what happens. Now, the next thing that you're going to say, well, I can't afford a vet. And I get that too. Veterinary care is not inexpensive. And it usually all comes out of our pocket because there's very little in the way of insurance out there. There are some horses that are insured, but even that is limited. And most of us don't have insurance on our pets or our livestock. So it's out of pocket and it's expensive. You know, a lot of veterinarians use ultrasound, they use x-ray, they have expensive drugs. I mean, yeah. But you have to plan for it. I know a lot of you follow Dave Ramsey and he tells you to have emergency funds. I'm going to tell you, if you want to have livestock on your place, you need to have an emergency fund for your livestock. And it's going to vary by what you have and how many. But if you have a horse, I'm going to say you need a $500 emergency fund. That's just a minimum, because they're like accidents waiting to happen most of the time. And the younger the horse, the more they tend to be accident prone. And it's a bigger animal. Usually the bigger the animal, the more expensive the care. So, you know, try to have an emergency fund. So when those things come up, you aren't scrambling and you aren't making a really hard decision between finances and maybe even emotions. Maybe it's an animal you're very attached to and you don't want to put it down, but you can't afford the surgery, you can't afford the treatment. And if you have an emergency fund, at least that will take, you know, if it doesn't cover it, it'll take a lot of the edge off the whole payment. And how to afford that? Well, same way you afford anything, you save for it. If you're not good about having that money on hand, there's another way you can do it. And I've done this, and that's after you establish a relationship with a veterinary office and you have an account up there, just make payments to your account when you don't have anything due. So you're getting a credit balance. And I do that sometimes when I know I have spring shots coming up or a teeth floating or something I know it's going to be kind of pricey. I just start making payments to my vet so that by time the actual appointment rolls around, I've either got it covered or I've got a big chunk of it, you know, already paid for. But you can do that. And then that money is there if you need it, when you need it. And trust me, you have enough animals, you will need it eventually. Also, vets understand you don't have insurance. And they're usually pretty darn good with their established clients about letting you make payments, especially if you have something catastrophic happen. As long as you make payments on a regular basis, they're pretty good about letting you do it. So they're not the foes, guys. They are something that you need to incorporate into your homestead life as a necessary evil, if you will. I don't think of them that way, but if you need to, then think of it that way. But sooner or later, you're going to need one. And it's so nice to see a friendly face that you know, can give you a hug afterwards if it's something bad or feel sympathetic towards you than just, you know, this professional that distant and aloof. I've had vets waive their fees before with different times in my life. And yeah, that hug when you have to put an animal down, a beloved animal, that hug at the end can make all the difference in the world as to, well, it doesn't take away the pain, but it does soften the blow. So don't treat your vet as a pariah that you are trying to avoid. They are your friends and your allies. And they're professionals. And they love animals too. So, you know, get them into your life and accept that they're there and make use of them.